What is up, everyone? JD here. I hope you're doing well today. We're going to be doing the disassembly and maintenance of my SinCut Arc Blast. Let's get into it. All right, guys. As always, I recommend the WeHaBits. All the tools are linked down in the description. I think I linked the Audacious Concept driver over on GP Knives, but if not, just use the GP Knives link. It'll take you right on over there and just search for the Audacious Concept driver. This one here is a collab with Anzo, and I do have the Griffin tool one that's way up here off screen that you can't see. I have that one. I know I linked that, the Griffin tool driver, I'm pretty sure. I'm not sure. Because it's not available, so I'm not 100% sure. All right, anyway, let's get into the disassembly here. You're going to need T6 for the pocket clips because this is a bucket lock. Yeah, brand new lock I just invented right there. Because it is a button lock, you will need to remove the pocket clip, guys. And this is a great opportunity if you're doing the disassembly to go ahead and upgrade to the titanium. Just use my Amazon link to head on over there. They're like 10 or 15 bucks. You can get the titanium one and install that one. And I think it even replaces, I think it replaces the T6 with T8 hardware. All right, so we got the first piece of hardware out there. Make sure that you have this sandwich. If you're doing it like me, I recommend holding it down flat on the surface. I just do this so that you guys can get a peeky at what's going on. So we're going to take this one out. I always try this first, tight. Here, no, it's spinning on both sides. Yeah, it's spinning on both sides. I think it's spinning on both sides. Dang it. All right, so let's close it. What I use is, and these finger bit drivers, those are linked. I remember I've been asked so many times, I went back down and triple checked to make sure that they are linked. So I use like just a sandwich technique there to hold that in place. What I'm hoping to do is tighten this side and then come over here and use this to keep this one from moving so that I can disassemble it from this side. So that usually works. Sometimes it doesn't, but if it doesn't, just be patient. All right, so the spring is going to want to come out of here now, especially because it is closed for my safety. So I'm just going to open it and set everything down, sandwiched. And now we can start to go ahead and remove the scale with the button lock in it. Did I remove everything? Okay, just making sure. Could be just the tight tolerance, guys. But let's see here. I'm just wiggling slowly. I don't want it to slip and cut me. I don't want the spring to go flying. So there you go. All taken apart. Scale makers out there. I know you guys have asked to have a look-see there. You got your washer. It's a flat screw, but it does look like... Did they start making that captive? No, it just looks like those standoffs, they've milled them partly into the scale there. So I hope that helps you guys out there that look for that information. Here is your spring. I'm not going to do anything with that. I love the spring tension on there. And we'll go ahead and remove the button and the blade. Be very careful here. Let's do it this way, guys. There we go. All right. Can I get the washer out? Oh, the pivot wants to come out. That's fine. That'll work too. All right. So everything that we need is a part to clean, or everything that we need to clean is taken apart. I am off the screen a little bit. I'm trying to remember to check that. I think there was one video I was like, man, I went off the screen a ton. So this one is our top washer. Our top scale. This is our bottom scale. I'm not going to mess with anything as far as where everything sits on the pivot. I'm just going to clean it all up. And then we'll be good to go to take it and put it back together. Now, there is a little bit of lock stick on here. And this looks a little different. Let me get it up on the camera. It looks like the button is either tapered or stepped. Oh. That sucker ran away quick. My band-aid making it hard to see. Looks like it's tapered or stepped. I wonder if that's how they solved for the problem with lock failure. I don't know. It's very interesting. I don't think I've noticed that before. Take note, your washers Those things are facing with the stamped side closed out and the open side facing the blade. So let me just clean this all up the best that I can. And I keep this here to try to get in where the lock is touching and connecting. That would be the closed side and then the open side. All right, and just, clean it to your satisfaction. It's fairly clean. It's not really that dirty at all. We'll go ahead and start by, oh, I forgot to clean the washers. Man, let me get these bearings clean. We want them cleaned up so that when I re-lube them, they're good to go. They're fairly clean. I feel like a lot of the stuff that comes from CVV and Cincut, they come, fairly clean. I really rarely find that I have any issues with them being super, super dirty or anything like that. So the pivot I cleaned already. We're just going to go ahead and put a layer on here. There we go. And then I'm just going to work a coating onto the pivot itself. Dry my hands. We will reinstall the pivot. Man, it is super tight tolerances, guys. This isn't captive or anything, is it? No. Okay. Maybe I just had it at an angle and didn't realize it. Let me grab my. My son's home. My dog's barking. I don't know if y'all can hear that. Well, that did not want to come out easily, guys. I've never seen one like that. Let me just clean that. I'm going to set that to the side. Let me clean this off because that sucker was on there. It was super tight tooling. I'm going to put just a dab on that stop pin because it really did not want to go in there easily at all. All right, so we're good to go there. It may create a little bit of a problem when we go to put this back together. All right, let's hit up this first bearing. Very nice bearings. These are the 5 millimeter, I think it's 364 is the smaller size. These are definitely the thinner bearings. Okay. Let's grab the button and move that bearing out of the way. And we will slide everything back into place here. Oh, the button. No, don't slide down. The button didn't fall in. Okay. Now we got everything back into place. A little bit of a Jenga puzzle for sure to reassemble that. And then we will lubricate our last bearing, guys. And if you've watched to this point or you watched to the end, thank you. It does help the algorithm. If you're enjoying the video while you're down there, subscribe, leave a like, leave a comment. All that helps, and I really appreciate it because it lets me know that you appreciate the time and effort and energy that I've put into these disassembly videos. I get a lot of feedback that a lot of people do really appreciate and enjoy them, so I'm happy to continue to do them. Plus, I'm going to be doing it anyway just to make sure that everything's clean, lubed, and looking good. Did I clean in this hole? Because it looks a little lubricated. Let me see. This is the side that it didn't want to come out of, and I need to remember when I'm done here to go order my Nipex sized, smaller pliers, and maybe even some soft grip pliers for it. So I just want to clean really well in here to make sure there's no lube, no lock stick happening, or try to eliminate the lock stick. I don't think you can get rid of it completely. From here, it's pretty easy. If you line up your pivot, you can kind of feel the spring fall into its hole. Usually, there it is. Yeah, that was a big drop. Okay, yeah, everything went together very nicely. Let's go ahead and get the two pieces of hardware that are not on the pocket clip started. I think the other side is tight enough to get that to go in nice and smooth. Sweet. I think the other side's spinning already. That's okay. We'll take this T8 and fasten down the body or the scale. Oh, it's trying to magnetize there. Okay. There we go. I think the other side's spinning. So I'm taking it apart and I'm not going to push the button, but I am going to, that feels dangerous. I'm going to close it and try to use my thumb to keep that from spinning and see if I can get this to close. There we go. All right, let's just check before we get to the pocket clip. I'm centered. Good action. No play. Lock stick. It's more like of a grab now. Nah, let me see. There's no play. I wonder if I have it a little too tight still. Let's see if I can back it out ever so slightly. Oh, that moved really easy. Yeah, that moved too easy. Let's try it now. Nope, too tight. Too tight, too tight. I wonder if it's because this side is too tight now. Let's see. I might have to use some thread locker, guys. All right, let's see. Still centered. No play. All right, I'm being stubborn. Let me just back it out a little bit more. If it comes out, I'll throw some thread locker on there. Why is it? There we go. Yeah, it's still a little too tight. Still a little too tight. I wonder if it's because this side needs to back out some. Ooh. Still centered. No play. If you ever wonder why people don't like captive, non-captive pivots, here's why. Is it, did I over-tighten the body screw? Let's do one side at a time. There we go. It just needed a little bit more adjusting. And there's no play. So there you go. Let's throw the pocket clip back on really quick. And that'll wrap up the video, guys. That is everything for the disassembly and maintenance for your Sincut Arc Blast. This would be, oh, let me show this to you. Longer screw goes into the body screw hardware on the back side. And if you're flipping your pocket clip over to a titanium one, I would probably say make sure you use the longer screw for the back. Oh boy. Why are you, Mr. Middle Screw, our front screw being a pain? All right, that's going in. Let's make sure that goes into the body first. Ooh. get this one tightened down a little bit more. Yep. There we go. Everything's tight. Hope you enjoyed this one. I hope it helped you. If you have a Arc Blast, pretty easy maintenance. Keep an eye on your pivot screws in case they need thread locker, but feels pretty much, lock stick still feels like it's pretty much needing to be broken in. If it was on a scale of 1 to 10, maybe that's what I'll start doing with these button locks. 10 being the worst, 1 being the best, I'd call it about a 4, 4.5. So hopefully that helps. I don't know if that helps because I haven't done it up until this video, but I'll start incorporating that going forward. So I hope that it helps. Shout out to everyone out there for hanging out to this point, guys. I appreciate you. I love you. Hope you have a fantastic week. Until next time, peace.